Hello and welcome to this first look at Bumpin Dungeon, a swipe-based mini-puzzle game with a retro-inspired chiptune soundtrack and aesthetic. It's available on both the App Store and Google Play starting July 10th, and I'll be sure to leave the link in the description. I'm Nick Culbertson, the lead developer on the project, and I'll be talking a little bit about what went into creating Bumpin Dungeon. The first thing I think players will notice about the game are the cutesy graphics. I love the Pico 8 look, and that's what I was going for. A little bit more on Pico 8 in a bit. These colors are instantly recognizable to me, and I'm glad I got to use their palette for this project. One of the inspirations for the game came from an art jam I was having with some friends. My buddy Bobby Fry, who's now a pixel artist at Bonus XP, was at the jam, and he made both the crab and the gerblin that can be seen in Bumpin' Dungeon. They were actually made for a different project, but that project got canned, and I thought it'd be cool to make a dungeon crawler environment around those characters, so that's what I did. So the art for the game started in Pico 8, which I mentioned, and that is a mini game development fantasy console. So it's a program where you can make games and music and all these different things, but one of the cool features about it are this sprite creating asset that's built into it. And I used that to start making these characters, and ultimately, when the programming started, I started and finished using Unity for the rest of the project. I used Unity for my previous game, Synthwave Escape, which you can check out too. I'll leave the link in the description. So, it was a natural fit to start there. Unlike Synthwave Escape, Bumpin Dungeon was created from scratch using no pre-existing assets. There are 120 levels in the game, but many of them, their sole purpose are to teach you a new mechanic. For example, one of the levels you saw earlier, the player stepped on a light block to open the door. As the game progresses, you'll continue to see those mechanics used in unexpected ways. You have a limited number of steps to make it to the exit, which makes optimizing use of these mechanics crucial. You'll encounter teleporters, enemies, spikes, and a bunch more things as you go through the game. But real quick, I wanted to give another shout out to Daniel Fairley, who had a similar lighting tile system in his game Dark Way Down. It's still available on Google Play, and I definitely recommend checking it out. So next, let's talk a little bit about the music in the game. It was all generated using a free website called Beepbox.com. Once again, I'll drop the link in the description. This site allows you to create chiptunes in a browser using an intuitive interface. If you've ever tried using a chiptune tracker, they are anything but intuitive, which made this a real good find. There are 10 songs in total. After exporting the WAV files, I sent them into GarageBand for final mixing, and I'm really happy with the outcome. I'm planning to package the soundtrack together for release on Bandcamp or Spotify, but that's a task to tackle for another day. Of course, we needed a hero, and that's where the blue-haired Hanny comes in. She is a fearless adventurer that you'll learn more about as you play through the game. To have a story resonate, it has to come from somewhere personal. And in the case for Hanny, she's entirely inspired by my 2-year-old daughter, Hannah. I wanted the player to feel like they were protecting this character as she navigated the maze, while learning new things along the way. There is a short coming-of-age story that is told as you progress through the game, but I'll leave that for you to discover. Well, at this point, I'm just starting to give away spoilers, so I'll leave you with this. If you like puzzles and dungeons and old-school retro games, check out Bumpin Dungeon. It's free on both Android and iOS, and I really hope you like it. If you get stuck on a level, just keep cracking at it. I promise there is a solution. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you all next time.